In this chapter, we got to know the concert. Part one, we got to know that this is a true story depicting love of a sister towards her brother. Okay, this lesson is written by Shanta Rameshwar Rao, who is a notable dancer from India. Okay. Now we got to know about Anand, who was a 15 years old and was suffering from cancer. Okay, and his sister named Smita, 16 years old, had struggled to fulfill her brother's desire. Can you all tell me the meaning of concert in the chat box? Can you all tell me the meaning of concert in the chat box? Yes, the concert means a musical performance, a performance of music. Yes, performing in public, performing of something on stage. Yes, correct. Okay, Angela, no problem. Last 5 minutes I'll give you. If at all that time your network is proper, we will have that thing. Okay, Ria says, and public performance by music or dance at stage. Yeah, exactly correct. So basically this chapter is revolving around the concert. The boy wanted desperately to attend this concert as he feels that attending the concert is a chance of a lifetime. And he was not allowed by his mother to attend the concert because he was very, very ill. Okay, he was suffering from what, students? He was suffering from what? Yeah, he was suffering from cancer. So for the treatment, for the hope that miracle would take place, they were coming from which place to which place? For better treatment, they migrated from which place to which place? Yes, from place called Gaganpur to Bombay. Okay, yeah, and they stayed at whose home? They resided at whose home? Aunt Sushila's. Yes. So later on, Smita was quite depressed, and she want as she and her brother used to do all the things together. They both wanted to attend this concert together, but mother did not allow Anand to attend this concert, whereas she told Smita, you can go and attend the concert with your father. Your father will get the ticket. So Smita was depressed. She was crying. And then Aunt Sushila suggested her that just relax, go to the park. Okay. Smita took this suggestion. Okay. And she went to the park. In park, everyone were walking, running, playing balls, doing yogic exercise. That time she was there in a deep thought. Till here we had covered. Now moving ahead. Now suddenly a daring thought came to her mind. Now what was that daring thought? They have not told us. Okay? That we will get to know after few paragraphs. So suddenly a daring thought, daring, courageous thought, a bold thought came to her. And she hurried. Very quickly she went to her home and she said to herself, why not? Why not? There's no harm in trying it. Once she was lost in her own thoughts, suddenly a daring thought came into her mind and she hurried home. Okay. And then she started talking to herself that why not? There is no harm in trying it. Okay. Then later on, she said to her mother that it would be nice to go to the concert. I don't know when we will get another opportunity to hear Pandit Ravi Shankar. Okay. So over here, she is telling that she wanted to go to Pandit Ravi Shankar's concert. Earlier, she denied. Now, after that thought, she is telling her mother that she wants to attend the concert. And her father agreed to get the tickets. Her father agreed to get the tickets. Okay, now over here in this particular paragraph, you can see to go, okay, to get, to hear, which go here and get is a verb over here, right? 2 plus base form of verb is called as which grammar part it is? Yes, Riya, exactly correct. It is infinite form of verb. Okay, so in grammar, 1 mark question is compulsory on it. Okay, so next paragraph tells us that about Smita and her father leaving for the concert. Okay, so moving in the next paragraph, the next day, Smita and her father were leaving for the concert. Her brother smiled. What did Anand do? Anand smiled. Smiled and he said, enjoy yourself. Enjoy yourself. Means Anand is telling to Smita that enjoy. What Anand is telling to Smita? To enjoy. To be in the moment. Though the word came out of painful gasp. Now, I already told you all the meaning of gasp. What does it mean? Can you all tell me? What is the meaning of gasp? In previous class, I had told you the meaning of it. Yes, catch breath, Sanskriti replied. Okay, open with open mouth. Yeah, breathing heavily with the help of mouth. Okay, it is not internal voice. I'll tell you the meaning again. Gasp means a short, quick breath of air taken through the mouth. When you are in pain or you are surprised, okay? So, lucky you. What is this gesture over here? He's smiling. What is the gesture over here? He's smiling. But at the same time, he's there in a pain. And is telling, lucky you. This means gesture is of smiling. But in the way he is hurt somewhere that he is not able to attend the concert. He is giving wishes to his sister that lucky you, attend the concert and enjoy the concert. Okay, moving ahead now. I hope that this paragraph was clear. Yes, correct, Dhamesh. Next paragraph tells us about this scenario. When she and her father were attending the concert, sitting besides her father, Smita was sitting next to her father in the gallery. What's feeling are filling your mind? So what does I repeat myself? Smita was sitting beside her father in the gallery, and Smita suddenly heard a thundering noise, a loud noise. Okay, and this was all of sudden because she was not there in the conscious state that what is happening around her. She was present over there, but in back of her mind, something was going in her mind. And what was that something? That daring thought was there in her back of her mind. Okay, so the thundering welcome means loud noise of welcoming. The audience were greeting and welcoming the great masters. We say no, yay, yuppie, and we clap. Okay, we howl, right? The same way the audience were reacting. They were very happy to see the great masters performing on the stage. Yeah, clapping. Yes, Sahil. Exactly correct gesture you have told. Next, I hope that this line is clear. Yes, voice echoing also. Yes, Sanskriti. So, can I move towards the next point? Okay, cool. Then the first note. Over your notes means the tune. The first note came over the air. Suppose I am playing some sound, background music is going on, and Smita is able to hear that particular note, tune. So she is feeling that particular moment. She's there into that moment. This point tells us about the Smita's feeling. Then the first note came over the air and Smita felt as if the gates of land of enchantment. Now, enchantment. What? Encampment means a feeling of great pleasure, happiness, yes, fascinating, delightful. So she felt that the gates have been opened and she is entering to that through that gate. Okay? Entering through and wonders were opening. Spellbound means what? Getting deeply involved in whatever is going on with complete attention. She was held with complete attention as though by magic. You are listening to the concert. Yeah, kind of hypnotized, Bhumi. Kind of hypnotized. Yes, speechless also you all can say. So spellbound means over here, she was there completely in the flow of those tunes. She listened to the unfolding ragas. Unfolding rag means what? Unfolding means gradually developing or being revealed. One by one tunes were coming. No, over here, Bhumi, it means unfolding means tunes were coming one after another. And over here, rag, I already told you all the meaning of it. A musical mode in classical music. So one mode, yes, exactly correct, Neha. So one by one modes were coming to her ears. These slow plaintive notes. Plaintive means what? The sounding sad, yes, dry, sad, and the fast twinkling one. And suddenly the quick twins were, notes were coming, ragas were coming. But all the while, the plan she had decided on the evening before. On the evening before means what? Previous evening, she went to the park. She had planned something. So that thought, that plan were there in her mind. Yes, last evening. And remained firmly. The word firmly means what? Strongly it was there in her mind. She was lost in the music, in the concert. Okay. But over here, she did not forget that for what purpose she was attending this concert. The chance of a lifetime, she heard Anant voice in every beat of tabla. Whenever she was listening to the beat of tabla, she felt like Anand is speaking through the beat of tabla and he's telling the chance of a lifetime. The chance of a lifetime, he wanted to hear Pandit Ravi Shankar's concert. I hope that this stanza is clear. In this stanza, we got to know that she was sitting and attending the concert with her father. Initially, she was not aware about the things as she was there in her own thoughts. Later on, she was mesmerized by the concert. But then too, the thing was there. The purpose was there in her mind. Yes, moving ahead now. Okay, the concert came to an end. Okay, the concert came to an end. The audience gave the artist a standing ovation. Standing ovation means what? The audience stood and they were mesmerized, means they were into it. Okay, spellbound. Okay, so standing ovation was given. Artist means the great people who are performing on the concert. Professional entertainer, singer, or anyone. Over here, it is a musician, okay? Classical musician. So, standing ovation was given to the artist. Is the word clear? This word, again, I tell you, a professional entertainer, singer, or dancer. Standing ovation means what? Stood and they were clapping. They were, the audience was standing and they were clapping. You can see behind picture is there of standing ovation. You all do something great in the school and you get standing ovation. Yes, student applause. Moving ahead. Before I move ahead, I'll show you all one video of the Pandit Ravi Shankar and Ustad Allaraka. Okay? From this particular video, you will be able to connect this particular point. Okay? This particular point you will be able to connect. The plaintive notes and the fast twinkling ones. Okay? So let's see the video. Okay, after this video, we will continue with seen the video. Now we'll continue. The concert came to an end. The audience gave the artist a standing ovation. Now a large
Mustachioist, having a long mustache man made a long boring speech. Now you can see in this particular picture, having the long mustache. Okay, yeah, this is a mustache. So the person with large mustache, long mustache, was giving a very very boring speech. Was giving a very boring. Now am I audible? Yes, Neha, thank you. So after this, after the video, next paragraph tells us about the mustachioist man's personality. Okay, this large mustachioist man having a long mustache made a long boring speech. Now, the students too. So this large mustachioist having a long mustache man made a long boring speech. Okay, then came the presentation of bouquet. After his boring speech, there came a presentation of bouquet. This bouquet was given to the guest. Then more applause. Applause means what? Clapping. Okay, then the curtain came down. This stage, they were sitting on the stage after the presentation of bouquet, people started clapping again, and then the curtain came down. The people, after this curtain came down, means what does it tells us? What does it resembles us? That the show was over. After the show was over, the people began to move towards the exit. Yes, correct, Sanskriti and Neha. The show ended and people were moving towards the exit. Now, this particular paragraph tells us about the speech, about the bouquet presentation, about the applause, about the clapping, drop down of the curtain, and after the end of the show, people were moving towards the exit. I hope this paragraph is clear and the words too. Moving ahead now. Next paragraph tells us about what did Smita do. Smita felt now was the time. Now was the time is what? Now this is the time. This is a chance. Smita felt when people are moving towards the exit, this is a chance to execute her plan, to execute her daring thought. So Smita wriggled her way through the crowd towards the stage. The word wriggled means, yes Neha, the word wriggled means twisting or turning the body quickly towards the stage. Yeah, she was there in this crowd and suddenly she moved towards the stage. Then she went up the steps. Then she went up these steps that lead to the wings. Over here, wings means either of the unseen backstage area on the side of a stage. You can see in this particular picture as well, over here, this area and this area behind the curtain is called as wings. It is a backstage area which is not seen by the audience. So somehow she came out of the crowd and she went towards the stage, and then she climbed the steps and she was there in the wing area. In this area she was there. Okay, moving ahead now. Then her heart started beating loudly. Her heart started beating. When your heart starts beating loudly, when you're anxious, when you're there, when you're surprised, okay, that heartbeat you can feel now. Okay, when we are scared, yes, definitely. So when she reached, because she has done something wrong without permission, instead of exiting, she went towards the stage. So her heart started beating loudly. In the wings, she saw a small crowd had gathered to talk about the evening concert. Okay, once after your function, what do the teachers do? We discuss about the function, about the concert. Okay, so in the same way, this small crowd from the people who were there from the arrangement of concert, they were discussing about the concert, about the evening. To help, some people were carrying the bouquet, presentation, teacup, and the instruments. Okay, then she went up this step. That led to the wings. Her heart started beating loudly. In the wings, a small crowd had gathered to talk about the evening concert, to help carry bouquet, teacup, and instrument. Moving ahead now, what she did? He was there. She noticed that Pandit Ravi Shankar was standing with the man who played tabla for him. The great wizard of music. The great wizard, the word wizard over here means someone who is expert in something. Exactly correct, Neha. Over here, the person was expert in playing tabla. Ustad, the word ustad means an expert or highly skilled person. Especially over here, it is musician. Over here, it is a Allah Rakha. Ustad Allah Rakha. Now, Smita. Sorry. Okay. After going on the stage, she observed few of the activities done by the crew people. Okay. And then later on, she saw Pandit Ravi Shankar was standing with the man who played the tabla, and the person's name was Ustad Allah Rakha. Her knees felt weak. Her knees felt weak. Her tongue. Right. When we feel this kind of feeling? When do we feel this kind of feeling? When we are anxious, when we are worried, when we are there in fear, when we are scared, when we are nervous. Yes, Neeraj, correct. When we are nervous, that time we get this kind of feeling. We feel like we are not having any sense. Okay. So her knees felt weak. Her tongue dried. She was anxious. She was nervous. Okay. To talk to such a great musician. To talk to. Yeah. When we go in front of big personality or anyone. In front of our parents also, I get anxious sometimes. Okay. So over here, but she went up, then she was anxious, she was worried, okay? Then too, she went up and stood before Pandit Ravi Shankar and Ustad Allah Rakha. She had folded her hands and she bursted out. The word bursted out over here means, burst out means to say something suddenly. She said suddenly, "Oh, sir." Okay, she went up on the stage. She stood before these two personalities. She had kept her hands folded. Okay, because she was anxious, she was worried. Okay, and then she bursted out. She said suddenly, "Oh, sir." Okay, and then the Pandit Ravi Shankar replied, "Yes." He asked questioningly but kindly, in a generous, in a very kind manner. He asked, "Yes." And then she started telling her story. And her story came pouring out. The word pouring out means what? She started talking freely to the person. To talk freely about something personal. So she started sharing her story about her brother who lay sick at home. Lay sick at home means who is a bedridden. And of how he longed to hear him and the Ustad play. He longed. Though over here, the word longed means wish, strong desire. Okay? So over here, when Pandit Ravi Shankar said yes, she started sharing her story about her brother, okay, to Pandit Ravi Shankar, who wanted to, the boy wanted to hear Pandit Ravi Shankar and Ustad. Okay? And then she requested, then Smita requested to Pandit Ravi Shankar Will you come to Aunt Sushila's house and play for him? She asks at the end, breathlessly. Breathlessly means what? Once we are there in the flow, we are continuously going on talking and talking and talking. And last statement was there. And then we do, yeah, done, completed. Okay? So breathlessly is in a way that involves gasping for breath developed due to exertion. Yes, hush. In short, Neha, correct. Please, she begged, please come. Then she took a pause and she again requested Pandit Ravi Shankar, please, please come. Yeah. Next paragraph tells us that how did this person stopped this little girl, okay? So a large mustachious man who was giving the presentation, who was giving a long boring speech, had was trying to stop Smita. Little girl, said the mustachious man who had made the long speech. Pandit ji is a busy man. Pandit ji is who over here? Pandit ji is Pandit Ravi Shankar, who is master. Okay? You must not bother him. The word bother means disturb. With such request, you should not disturb, you should not bother, you should not trouble Pandit ji with such a request, because this man is a very busy person. Okay? And how can you request? This was the look of that mustachious man. Yes, the host of the show. Moving ahead now. Next paragraph tells us that Pandit Ravi Shankar smiled. Pandit Ravi Shankar smiled and motioned. Motion means giving sign. Sign over here. Motion, giving head movement, eye movement. Okay? In a way, he gave a sign to him. Motioned him to be quiet. Who is him over here? Him is a mustachious man who was giving the long, boring speech. So Pandit Ravi Shankar motioned him to be quiet. He turned to Ustad Sahib and said, what shall we do, Ustad Sahib? Ustad Sahib means what? Sahib over here is a word which means companion. Companion means what? This person is accompanied by Pandit Ravi Shankar. Is giving company. Yeah, partner we can say. Okay, companion. So, Ustad, I told you the meaning of Ustad. I told you the meaning of Sahib as well. Moving ahead now. The Ustad moved the pan. Word means what over here? A soft compressed lump. Yes, Neha. So, he moved the pan from one cheek to another. Tomorrow morning, we will perform for the boy. Yes, he said. So over here, Ustad Alaraka said to Pandit Ravi Shankar that tomorrow we will present front of the boy. Tomorrow we will present for the boy. Pandit ji replied, yes, it's settled then. It's settled over here means, the word settled means it is decided. It is fixed. Tomorrow morning we are going to perform for the boy. It is fixed. Word of pan. Pan, we all of us know that it is a betel leaf, okay? It is a leaf of betel plant. No, it is not a food. It is a betel leaf, okay? And in that, we have mixtures of fruits, dry fruits, nuts, okay? And we have after our lunch. The word vad means a soft compressed lump or mass of something. So, it was a mass of pan in the cheek of Ustad Alaraka. Okay, Bhumi, let's move ahead now. Next paragraph tells us when she got to know that Pandit Ravi Shankar agreed, and even Ustad Alaraka agreed that yes, they are going to perform for her brother. She was quite happy. She was quite excited. Can you give me your expressions with the help of emoji in the chat box? Yeah, Riya, good. Other students? Yes. In PC also, you can have emojis. shortcut key is their Sanskriti. Yes, so she was blessed, she was very happy. Okay, how, and she it was very excited. Smita was very excited at that particular moment, and she reached home late that night. But Anand was awake. He wanted to listen the review from Smita. How was the show? How well she enjoyed? So Anand was awake, breathing the oxygen from the cylinder. Then Anand said, did you hear him? He whispered in a soft voice. He said this to Smita. Then Smita replied, I did. And I spoke to him. Him over here is Pandit Ravi Shankar. Okay. I spoke to Pandit Ravi Shankar. Pandit Ravi Shankar said that he is going to come tomorrow early in the morning and with the tabla ustad. Okay. And they will play for you. After hearing this, even Anand was quite happy. And the following morning, the word following over here means the next morning. Okay, after the concert, the next morning, Aunt Sushila's neighbor observed. They saw two men get out of taxi and pulled up outside their block. Their block means what over here? Outside their building. Outside the neighbors were observing that two men were getting out of the taxi. And the taxi was stopped near the neighborhood's building. Okay, they could not believe their eyes. Is it? It's not possible. What did neighbor said? Is it? Is it means what? Is this people the great musician Ustad Alarakha and Pandit Ravi Shankar? It's not possible. They were not able to believe. They were not believing. Yeah, they were shocked. They said over your neighbor said. Okay, moving ahead now. Last paragraph it is there. Pandit Ravi Shankar and Ustad Alarakha went up the wooden stair, knocked softly on the door of Aunt Sushila's apartment. Then they went in and sat on the divan. Divan means bed, sofa, whatever you called it as furniture. Okay. By the window, this furniture, this divan was there next to the window and played for the boy. Played over here means performed for the boy. Surrounding him with a great and beautiful happiness as life went out of him gently, very gently. This word, this phrase, this line means that lastly Anand died. Yes. So his last wish got fulfilled because of his sister, and then he was able to leave his breath slowly, slowly, and he died. Okay. So, can we have a quick recap session? Okay. Can I ask you all questions? Okay. My first question to you all is, who said to whom, tomorrow morning we perform for the boy? Yes. Tomorrow morning we perform for the boy? Yes. Who said to whom? No. Again, I'm repeating my question. Tomorrow morning, we perform for the boy. See this paragraph. Yes. Oh, Ustad Sahib said this to Pandit Ravi Shankar and it was heard by Smita. Okay. Now tell me the meaning of wriggled. Tell me the meaning of wriggled. Twist, turned, yeah.